here at Trinity Lutheran Church in Watertown, Minnesota. This is our prelude as people are joining us. This song was requested to do sometime, so today this is our prelude. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 Welcome to worship here. This is our prelude at Trinity this morning as we begin to gather online for this service. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. The joy of the Lord is my strength. This song was requested by one of the members of the Priscilla Circle. They like to sing this song whenever they get together. It's a favorite for many of them. So this is for you. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 Good morning and welcome to worship here at Trinity Lutheran Church in Watertown, Minnesota. I'm grateful to be here with all of you. Grateful that you are here as well. My name is Pastor Jeff Engholm. I'm glad to be here. Joining me today is my wife, Susan Engholm, who's helping lead worship today. If you'd like to follow along with a bulletin, you can find that on our website at trin.org. Just go to where it says online worship, scroll down, you can find a bulletin that you can follow along with. Although you don't have to have that today, simply follow along with us and we will lead you through today's service. If you're joining us today, make a little comment below there at the bottom. Just let us know you're here. Say hi to us and hi to everybody else who's joining us here. Many people are finding us here this morning online, and I'm grateful that we can be here together because, you know, it continues to be a strange time we're living in. It continues to be strange that we're not here together. But I'm grateful that in this way, we can be here and together. Our opening song is another request when we asked for these on our Facebook page a week or so ago. A number of them came in. If you have requests for songs, you can simply comment on, make comments about that as well. But this one was requested. It goes like this. When upon life's billows, you are tempest-tossed. When you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done.
Count your many blessings, angels will attend. the dead, for he is alive and has become the Lord of life. Help us to shine with the light of Christ, so that we might share that light with those around us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We are still in the season of Easter, so we still proclaim the Lord is risen by saying the Lord is risen, and you say the Lord is risen indeed. Let's say that. The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Moms and dads, others who are older are welcome to get another cup of coffee. You can stick around too if you want, but this is just for the children. I have something to show you all today. Take a look at this. This is not a guitar, but it looks a little bit like a guitar. It's actually a dulcimer. It's got strings on it, but you don't play it like a guitar. You actually put it in your lap. That's why it's called a lap dulcimer, and you play it like this. It's called a dulcimer because dulce, the beginning of it, means sweet. There are sweet little sounds that come out of this little thing that's kind of like a guitar, but not, it's its own thing. It's a little dulcimer. I play this today because these sweet sounds remind us of the sweet lives that we live together and how everything that we say with our words and lips, think and feel inside of our minds and hearts are reflected in the lives that we live in all of our actions. So there's a little prayer I want to teach you that goes, Father, grant that what we sing with our lips, we may believe in our hearts. And what we believe in our hearts, we may show forth in our lives through our Lord Jesus Christ. With the sweet sounds of the dulcimer, it sounds like this.
Father, grant that what we sing
Our reading today comes from 1 Thessalonians, the first chapter. Paul, Silvanus and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction, just as you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord, for in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit. This is the word of the Lord.
Grace and peace to you from God Almighty, the one who calls us to faithful living and changing lives. Amen. I love this reading that we just heard today from the book of 1 Thessalonians. By the way, don't get hung up on that word, Thessalonians. It's just the name of the people who lived in a place called Thessalonica. They were Thessalonians. It's simply like calling someone from America an American. Or if you're from Germany, I guess you're a German. If you're from Italy, you're an Italian. It's just the name of the people who lived in that place. But this book is actually a letter. It was a letter that was written to the Thessalonians by a man named Paul. It's actually some of the oldest writings in the New Testament. I know it doesn't come first in the New Testament, but they didn't put them in that order. These are some of the very oldest, very first thoughts ever written down in the early church. And what are those first thoughts written down by this man named Paul? Here's his very first thought in his very first letter that he wrote to his friends in this very early church. He opens like this. Grace to you and peace. Let's stop right there. In the church back then, just like in the church now, the life of faith is always grounded first and foremost in the grace and peace of God. If you forget everything else that I say today, just remember that much. Our life together is grounded in the grace and peace of God. But then he goes on, I always give thanks to God for all of you. Yeah, our life together is not only grounded in the grace and peace of God, it's also grounded in gratitude. We live our lives as a grateful people, thankful for those around us, thankful for the life that we live, thankful for the gifts that we receive from the hand of God. But then Paul goes on. He talks specifically about what he is thankful for in their lives. He writes, I'm thankful for your work of faith. I'm thankful for your labor of love. I'm thankful for your steadfastness of hope. Their work of faith, their labor of love, their steadfastness of hope. It wasn't easy back then for those folks. Life was kind of hard. Life was a struggle. Life was very unpredictable. Kind of like now, when life is hard, and life is a struggle, and life is certainly unpredictable. But they made it together, not perfectly, not easily, but they made it through back then, just like we are making it through now. And then he closes his opening words of thanks like this. Brothers and sisters, beloved of God, God has chosen you. He calls them brothers and sisters, as if they're family, which they are, the family of faith, all children of God. And he reminds them that they've been chosen by God, picked by God, called by God to live their lives of faith, hope, and love together. No matter where they are, no matter what they are doing. I know this all sounds kind of simple, right? And yet it's so easy to forget. I forget it too. It wasn't long ago I was trying to cover all the bases of the work to do, all the bases, all the time, no matter where I was, no matter what I was doing, and no matter where I was or what I was doing, I was sure I was in the wrong place, doing the wrong thing, at the wrong time. And then I read this little post. It was online. From Nikki. Nikki is a physician's assistant. She's a PA. And she happens to be married to my nephew, Kyle. They live down in Southern Illinois with their three kids. Here is just a part of what she wrote about being a PA and a mom on Facebook. We are currently celebrating the healthcare heroes of the world. And as someone who works in this industry, let me say they are heroes right now. But I've been reflecting all week as I've been home, protecting, loving, learning with my kids, struggling to find the balance between home and work. She goes on. So friends, if you are feeling the same way, if you are questioning how your days are being spent, God knows exactly where you are needed. If you are working at home and spending your days loving, teaching, and protecting your family, you are heroes too. You are seen, loved, and valued. And God is using you in a mighty way during this season. I needed to hear that a while ago, and I still need to be reminded of that every day. I don't know. Maybe you do too. It's easy to wonder if we're doing what we're supposed to be doing. Wonder if we are where we are supposed to be. But here's the thing, in the midst of this pandemic, nobody knows for sure exactly where we're supposed to be. We're all just kind of making this up as we go along the best we can. And so Nikki's words remind me, at least, to simply remember that we are called on this strange journey to trust each other, support each other, help each other out along the way, and most importantly, to remember that God is with us, helping us sort all this out, guiding us along the way. This letter to the Thessalonians is as true now as it was the day it was written. We are brothers and sisters, beloved by God, every single one of us. And we do live by faith, hope, and love. And we will give thanks to God for each other and all that God has given us. And above all, we will remember that our lives are grounded in the grace and peace of God. No matter where we are, no matter what we are doing. Amen. May the peace of God that passes all understanding keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Here's a simple song. It's about how we're called to live our lives together. In holy, thankful, and hopeful ways. The words are, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness is what you want from me. The chorus is simple too.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You know what it's time for right now, right? It's time for the sharing of the peace or the sharing of the swag, S-W-A-G, our smiles, our waves, and our greetings with each other. If you're with some folks now, just do that right now with whoever you're with there. And if you're not with anybody, do it this way. Hello to you. I'm smiling. Oh, yep, you're smiling too. And I see that waving. And I see some greeting coming from there. Good to see you and you. And yep, you there too. Glad to have everybody here worshiping and sharing our greetings there today. And don't forget, later on today, somebody else is waiting to get some swag from you, either through an email or a text or a phone call, or maybe even write an old-fashioned letter. I don't care. Share your greetings with somebody else who's just waiting to hear from you today. We're also collecting an offering today. We're grateful for that. We're first and foremost grateful for the offering that you share just of your own lives. That's the most important offering ever, just the sharing of your life with those around you. But we're also grateful for the financial gifts, the financial offerings that are coming here still to support the ministries here that continue to go on here in Trinity. So thank you to those of you who have been dropping them off, stopping by in the mornings when we're open a little bit during the week, or those of you who are mailing them in, thanks for that. And I know many of you are finding online ways of sharing that. And if you haven't figured that out yet, just go to our website, trin.org/give, and that'll help you learn more about sharing your gifts online with us. But I'll simply say thank you to all of you for all the ways you support the ministries here at Trinity with your financial gifts and in other ways.
Let's pray. Gracious Lord God, as this new day dawns, we're reminded of that first Easter morning when sorrow turned to joy, when despair turned to hope, and when love overcame death. During this strange time of uncertainty in our lives, when we have been reminded just how precious and fragile life is, may the peace that passes all understanding fill us with hope, comfort, courage, and peace. Amen. I invite you to join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And now may the Almighty God, Creator, Christ, and Comforter, keep you in God's light, God's love, and God's peace, now and forever. Our closing hymn, I'm going to lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside. I'm going to lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm going to lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside, down by the riverside. Study. will do this again. I'm going to shake hands around the world. I'm going to shake hands. Thank you for joining us here today for this worship. Glad to be together with everybody. We'll be gathering again Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. In the meantime, you know what to do. Stay calm, stay connected, and shine on. I'm going to shake hands.